Hi everyone, welcome back. Mark 47 of Need for Speed Most Wanted 2005. Last time we did Webster's Pursuit Milestones, so now we're finally going to challenge Webster Blacklist 5. So, yeah, two sprints and the speed trap though. Now basically, the speed trap and sprints are, they really are just pretty much the same track. Like, that's just really all it is for Racing 2. Oh, and speaking of that, so anyway, now that we're on Blacklist 5, we basically now have like three races in the Rival Challenge instead of two, obviously, just like in the previous ones. 15 through 6 has like two races. Well now that we're on Blacklist 5, now the race count is higher, obviously. Now we have three races on Blacklist 5 through 2. Obviously, so yeah, that's exactly what Blacklist 5 through 2 is. Three races instead of two. For Blacklist 1, well, once we get to it though, you'll see it coming in my race. But anyway, let's get to it. So yeah, so it's only just two sprints and the speed traps, so I don't even need to glitch those races. So, we're good. Sorry about that. Again, there was another interruption, pretty much. But anyway, Mom's already outside now, and I'm sure that in a minute or maybe a couple seconds, so she is gonna go to like ride on her bike, obviously. So yeah, hopefully I'll be able to get this recording done before she comes back. But yeah, anyway, back to the game. Suck it, Webster. I just flipped your car. Alright, next is a speed trap. Now, like I said, race 2 and race 3, it's exactly the same track. So, you could see it though. State in Petersburg, state in Warren, obviously. I'm not sure why that's a thing, but yeah. Start, isn't it? Okay, maybe not. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, yeah, it is a restart. Stupid game. Still beat me by 7 miles per hour because he's in the fast car, the Corvette C6. Such a bad driver or something? Well, at least I'm still ahead. Whoa, Webster, what are you doing? Take it easy. Yeah, I'm still ahead of Webster by 109 miles per hour. really care if Webster is ahead of me though, because I'm still gonna reach the finish anyway. Because yeah, I can still win the race. Alright, well that's good. Alright, now for the sprint, which is the same track as the speed trap. So yeah, same starting point, and you should be able to see the same finish line once we get there. Okay, there, I beat him. 48,000 cash for beating Webster. Alright, let's just hope I can get his Corvette. If I don't get it, then I'll have to cut this. I'll have to cut until I get it. Alright, let's hope we can get it first try. That was great. And I was, you know what? I wish I got two things. You know what? Well, let's just get at least a another Junkman burger. Since that now in this final, I didn't really go. I don't think I really went for most of these anyway. So I think I only like on like one, and it was like Junkman tires, and I just got that from Kaze. When I beat her, mostly. So yeah. On this new one, so yeah. Let's see what we get here. Supercharger, yes! Freaking love Supercharger. Or maybe it's just turbo upgrades, pretty much. Anyway. Blacklist 4. Joe Vega, otherwise known as JV. His strength is speed trap races. His ride is a Dodge Viper Sport 10. That's also a car I'm going to try to get. Now the good thing about the Viper is actually a little faster than the Gallardo and the Corvette. So yeah, I think the Viper Sport 10 is actually the best muscle car in the game, anyway. So yeah, that's one reason why I'm going to try to get it. But anyway, I don't know how JV does it, man. He's not just spent in the clubs and days on the streets. This guy's got a lot of street rep. Cops hate him and ragers want to be like him. This flash green Dodge Viper has cops swarming around it all the time. I mean, all the time. I'm not sure why the cops are dead. Maybe they're like addicted to his car. Razor.
Well, number 5 on the blacklist. Bravo, don't get too worked up, though. Because you see, you still got my guys to come through, and I got a feeling that things are going to get a lot tougher for you. A lot tougher.
I do hate to say it, but Razor is right, though. Like, since that now we're on Blacklist 4, this is where things are going to start to get more tougher. Because now, so basically now, this time the cops are going to get a little more aggressive, and the races are going to be more harder this time. So yeah, that kind of sucks, though, but hey, I can handle it. Anyway, let's check out the new car we just won from Webster, his Corvette C6. There it is. There's the Corvette. All right. Now, if you didn't notice, yeah, the Corvette is my favorite muscle car. Alright. Now, if you listen to it, check this out. That sounds more good than the Mustang. Well, Jules is Mustang. So yeah, good thing I really have a Corvette now, because yeah, the Corvette is exactly my favorite muscle car of all time. Anyway, so the only performance parts we've unlocked from from Webster is ultimate transmission and ultimate brakes. Now I just need to equip the ultimate nitrous on his Corvette, and there, it's maxed. And one more thing to do to the Corvette. Tune this thing up, because I really need to tune it up. For it to be competitive. Let's upgrade our RE84 or more. Since that now we have unlocked those performance parts from Webster, we should be able to get it. Anyway. So we did get at least a chunk of turbo jumping parts, so there we go. Now this thing is going to be a little faster on acceleration, tiny bit on top speed. So yeah, anyway, I fit the Jumpman turbo on there, and now let's get the unlocked parts from Webster, performance parts. So yeah, so if you forgot, ultimate transmission, ultimate brakes. That's the one you can unlock from Webster. Alright, now there's one thing left to show off, and we're going to go over the unlocked cars from Webster. So yeah. So again, it's two cars. And you'll see exactly what they are when we get there. Supposed to hit whatsoever. All right, so anyway, here are the unlocked cars from Webster. So first one here, the Porsche 911 Turbo S. Now basically, this thing is actually an okay car, obviously, on the top speed and acceleration though. And the handling is completely good. The handling is really good too, obviously, for this thing. At stock, and when this thing is like maxed out, well, I'm guessing it's still the same thing for top speed and acceleration. And I'm sure the handling is going to be much higher too. Like, this thing is exactly a grip master when you like max this car out. So yeah, if you do completely want to at least get this car at any point of the game after you beat Webster, then I'm not going to really lie to you because it is a good car actually. And last car we unlocked from Webster is the Corvette C6, which was the one Webster was driving. Now basically, this thing is faster than the 911 Turbo S, obviously. Maybe it's not that, but it is still kind of fast anyway. And the handling is just the same thing as the 911 Turbo S though. And when you think of things like maxed out though, I guess then it would be a speed car though, but not like too speed, honestly. So yeah, you completely might not know. But anyway. So anyway, yeah, the Corvette C6, it's really still a good enough car you can choose. Just in case. So yeah, if you do want to get either one of these two cars, obviously in the game, well, for these two, well, you can take either one of those. Like, they're both good enough cars, and yeah, they can absolutely handle race as well. So, yep. So yeah, feel free to really take one of these two if you want. Alright, so anyway, those were the unlocked cars from Webster. Alright, let's drive back to the safe house, and then I'm gonna be able to end it here. Now that I've completely gotten now that I got Blacklist 5 actually out of the way, basically now I can actually end here. Now this time in Blacklist 4, the race modes are still the same, and this time the milestones have changed, like I did explain last time. So back in Blacklist 5, you needed 4 milestones to challenge Webster. Well, for now, for JB, this time you need 5 milestones to complete in order to challenge JB. So, yep, not 4, it's 5 this time. So you need 7 race wins, 5 milestones, and 4,050,000 bounty. And which again, we already got the bounty already, so don't have to worry about that. Just have to worry about the race wins and the milestones, and then we should be good to challenge. Alright, so. So by the time I get done recording this, now I will really need to upload parts 43 through 47 before I start recording Blacklist 4. Oh, by the way, yeah, 43 through 47 is Blacklist 5. So Blacklist 4 will be parts 48 through 52. That's exactly what it's going to be. 48 through 52. So yeah, once I get Blacklist 5 uploaded, then I'll be able to start recording Blacklist 4. So be prepared for that. All right. Well, at least it is a good time to really end off the heel now, because I really got to two important things to do right now. I really got to like brush my teeth and I got to shave. Completely. So yeah. Alright, I gotta end it here now. So anyway, when we come back for part 48, we will start Blacklist 4 by doing JB's first few races. Alright, well, I'll see you then. I really must go into the bathroom now.